A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 6 December, on the front page you have PM Modi silent on economy, government clueless, Chidambaram. So, former finance minister P. Chidambaram is out on bail now and he has been said to not give any statement regarding the case to the media, but now he is out protesting and speaking on the economy. So, he says PM Modi is silent on economy. And government is clueless about what's going on. So, the economic slowdown, the rise in onion prices. So, on these issues, you can see ministers, Congress leaders are protesting. So, ministers, he says, are allowed to engage in bluff and bluster. There have been many such statements which have been given regarding the economy, regarding the finance minister herself, regarding how there has been a decrease in sale of vehicles, on which she said this is because of the Gen X using Ola and Uber. So such statements, irresponsible statements have also been given. Then here you have, in a surprise, RBI keeps interest rate unchanged. So this is the RBI Governor Shaktikant Das, who has said that interest rate will not change. It is at 5.15%, though there was expectation that interest rate would come down. He says that there is space for further policy action. So, he surprised the market. You can see this was the fifth bi-monthly monetary policy review since, you can see, Jan. And the market was expecting a interest cut. So, this is the key interest rate, the repo rate, which the RBI decides based on this. This is the rate at which banks borrow from RBI on short term. So, on the basis of repo rate, banks also align their interest rates. So, if repo rate goes down, it is expected banks would also bring their interest rates down, making the interest rates in the economy down, which would give a boost to the economy by making credit easily available. Loans is easy. So, but presently, repo rate has not changed. The key interest rate. Then below you have set ablaze Unnao rape victim battles for life. So the 23-year-old woman from Unnao in Uttar Pradesh is battling for life after she was set ablaze allegedly by 5 persons, including two she had accused of rape in March 2018. So she's in crucial condition with 95% burns now. And all the 5 accused in the case have been arrested. Earlier, we had seen also how in case of rape victim, the car in which they were traveling was rammed, and because of which the relatives of the victim as well as the advocate and herself were grievously injured. The aunts actually died. And this is 2018 Sabrimala verdict is not the last word. So, Chief Justice of India S.A. Bobade has orally remarked that September 2018 judgment of Supreme Court allowing menstruating women to worship at the Sabrimala temple might at the moment not be the last word, as the issue has been referred to a larger bench of 7 judges. So, larger bench of 7 judges would look into a general question on how far court can intervene in religious matters, and based on that response then further the review bench would look into this particular matter as such. And below you have FM faces pungent barbs over spiraling oil prices. So this is what we spoke of above, Mr. P. Chidambaram stating about irresponsible statements from leaders. And here you have one more irresponsible statement from finance minister. So here you can see she said, "I don't eat much of onion and garlic. I come from such a family which doesn't have much to do with onion." On which Congress leader Rahul Gandhi has said, "Nobody is asking you whether you eat onions. You are the finance minister and we are asking why the economy is struggling." So it's in response to such irresponsible statements, we see sharp criticism coming from the opposition. On page 3 you have 2-day street festival kicks off in Karol Bagh. So a 2-day street festival, Reclaim the Night, based on the theme of women empowerment, started at Ajmal Khan Road in Karol Bagh in Delhi. this is 26-year-old woman IPS IRS officer who says, "This is amazing. We do not stay out so late. We are just here. We are out just because of this festival." So women should feel safe at any time. So this is a festival which has been initiated in Delhi. Some stores remained open till 11 at night here, but some pulled down shutters by 9:30. So crowd also started thinning after that. So this is the festival. On page 4 you have Bhimrao Ambedkar, revered reformer, forgotten economist. So this is a tribute to Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, whose birthday is celebrated on 6th December every year. So you should know about his viewpoints and his contribution as such to his ideas on women's rights, on economy. He is already revered as the architect of India's constitution. So this article talks of how his ideas hold relevance even today. On page 5 you have Maharashtra team in Rajasthan to study loan waiver scheme. So Thackeray government wants to make state farmers loan free, and his team is here in Maharashtra to study Congress government's loan waiver scheme benefiting lakhs of farmers whose debts worth 15,000 crore have been set aside in 2018 and 2019. On page 8 you have missing boy traced within 24 hours after filing of zero FIR. So this is, you can see, the case of a zero FIR being registered. What is a zero FIR? It is an FIR which can be filed by any police station on a complaint irrespective of its jurisdiction. So zero FIR helps in case of victims. Recent case of rape and murder of veterinarian in Hyderabad has also given a boost to zero FIR initiative. And here you can see that, you know, because in this rape and murder case, the victim's family has alleged that police delayed filing the FIR citing jurisdiction. So this concept of zero FIR is quite relevant here. So you should know about it. On page 9 you have Firepower by India for India. So this is regarding defense deals which are worth 33,000 crore which have been placed with Ordnance Factory Board and Bharat Electronics Limited in the last 2 months. So these are indigenous, you know, defense equipments. So here you can see which are in the pipeline. Akash missile being tested. Then here you have the supplier of it is Bharat Electronics Limited. Integrated Advanced Command and Control System nodes. Then you have this is 464 T90 SK tanks. So these T90 tanks are being built by Ordnance Factory Board under license from Russia. So these are important equipments which are being manufactured in India. One by Ordnance Factory Board and two by Bharat Electronics Limited. So this is T90 tanks and this is Akash missile and integrated advanced command and control system nodes. Then here you have Diamond-Tier Nirav Modi, now a fugitive economic offender. So Special Prevention of Money Laundering Act court has declared diamond trader Nirav Modi, the accused in PNB scam case, a fugitive economic offender. So he is the second person to be declared so, the first one being Vijay Mallya. So he has been declared so under Fugitive Economic Offenders Act. So you should understand what the term means. Fugitive means you knew the, you know, the case, you have ran away from the country because of the case behind filed against you, and when a summon is noticed, issued to you, do not come back for hearing. So then he is called a fugitive. So this is for loans above crores as such. So those people can be declared as fugitive economic offenders. And below you have Amnesty India seeks time to furnish response to Enforcement Directorate. So Enforcement Directorate had served show cause notice to Amnesty India, the NGO, for allegedly violating FEMA rules, Foreign Exchange Management Act rules. So this is regarding 51.72 crore rupees involved. So NGO has sought more time to respond. Amnesty International is actually a UK based NGO. It's a Nobel Peace Prize winner, and it has its various arms. This is Amnesty International India Private Limited. Then on editorial page, the first editorial is bail basics. So this is regarding Chidambaram's bail plea being rejected. He been put behind bars for 106 days, which the Supreme Court has sharply questioned. And here you can see the Delhi High Court's ruling also, in which it accepted sealed statements from various investigating agencies and quoted them verbatim to deny jail to Mr. P. Chidambaram. So this has been criticized by Supreme Court, and it has ordered bail for Chidambaram. So the fundamental principles of granting bail have been restated. And this is the strategic pause. So this is regarding the front page news today. The interest rate has not been changed, the key interest rate. So RBI is waiting to see what is coming in the budget. So this is regarding that. Then the lead article, a potential seedbed for private profits. So this is regarding new seeds bill. So this is tilted against farmers' interests and loaded in favor of seed companies. So this bill of 2019 is under parliament consideration. So seeds, you know, they are purchased as actually, you know, high yielding variety seeds as such. So this protection of new varieties of plants convention is there, and even TRIPS, you know, regarding intellectual property rights, the TRIPS initiative of WTO. So all these call for protection of farmers as such. But here you can see the restrictions which are to be, you know, introduced on free use and exchange of seeds by farmers is owned unless the breeders were remunerated. So if breeders are getting remuneration, there is no need for restrictions. But the new bills actually go against the farmers. The government says a new seeds bill is essential because already there is a seeds bill of 2004 and 2010. So it says a new seeds bill is necessary to enhance seed replacement rates in Indian agriculture. So, and specify standards for registration of seed varieties and enforce registration from seed producers to seed retailers. So here the article says that, you know, shifting from farmers' seeds to certified seeds, this would raise seed replacement rates. This is desirable because certified seeds would have better yield than farmer saved seeds, but then there will be a cost incurred by the farmers. So such a shift should not be achieved through policing but through an enabling atmosphere. So this, you know, private seed companies prefer policing because their low volume, high value business model is crucially dependent on forcing farmers to buy their seeds every season. So this is a critique on this seeds bill. And below you have behind the rage, Iranians dream of democracy. So this is regarding the demonstrations in Iran. So usually triggered by high living costs, have ended up targeting the religious autocracy in Iran. So here the oil prices were increased and the protests were initiated, which are now demand for democracy, demand and, you know, demand for the religious autocracy ending in Iran. On Fridays on the op-ed page, you have this parley coverage in which a question, important question is asked. Here it is regarding electoral bonds. It says how electoral bonds made a bad system worse. So this article talks of, it's a view counter view given. So it says in disallowing voters from knowing the identity of donors, the scheme is even more opaque now. And this is lessons from Ambedkar. So this talks of how Dalits will be denied their due share of political power unless they remain united. On page 12, you have new norms made to make social media more accountable. So central government says social media companies must identify and remove harmful content without affecting privacy of users. So it was, government says it is working on rules to mandate social media companies for removal of such objectionable content like child sexual abuse material, rape images, content promoting terrorism. This should be removed without affecting privacy. And here you have Rajya Sabha clears bill to lower corporate tax rate. So this is an amendment which is replacing the ordinance for on taxation law. So it has been cleared by voice vote in Rajya Sabha. So it brings down the corporate tax rate for domestic companies from 30%, it is down to 25%. And this is for those with annual turnover over 400 crores. And here you can see this will be brought down to 22% if they don't claim certain exemptions. So from 30 and 25% it is down to 22%. On international page, you continue to have news regarding impeachment of President Trump. So this will wait and watch, not to be done right now. Then this is Maldives seeks to restructure Chinese debt. So this is what Foreign Minister of Maldives Abdullah Shahid has said. India's first policy is an expression of a geographical reality. So it says Maldives will seek to restructure 1.4 billion debt it owes to China. So India first policy, it says, will not come in the way of negotiations with the Asian giant China. China has been a generous donor to Maldives, and the relationship between the two countries is on a stable footing. So it wants these Chinese debt to be restructured. And this is France shuts down amid unions, Macron face-off. So this is regarding French President Emmanuel Macron and the unions, the trade unions. So the unions are protesting for pension overhaul. And here you can see demonstrations against government's pension reform plan. Sees a face-off between them and the president of France. So here you can see French President Emmanuel Macron. He is in power since 2017. And the French economy is highly regulated and aimed to open up the economy. But then powerful trade unions are against this. And they are demanding, you can see, reforms or an overhaul of the pension system. On business page, you have India's forex reserves cross $450 billion for the first time. So central bank is buying dollars to check sharp appreciation of rupee now. So here you can see India's forex reserve is at a record high. And this is regarding a glitch at an ATM of HDFC. So this issue is before the RBI now. The team from RBI is looking into the issue. It was HDFC Bank's mobile and internet banking platform which was affected. Sorry, not the ATM, but it was the internet and mobile banking which was affected. And this is an interview with RBI Governor Shaktikant Das. And this is RBI lays down guidelines for payment banks SFB license. So this is regarding license for payment banks and small finance banks. So small finance banks license, how would they be approved? So RBI has laid down guidelines for that. Approval will be only after 5 years of operation is what RBI says. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.